This video was made possible by Wix. If you are ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. It seems these days, killer plant movies aren't really in vogue. But in the past, those sometimes ridiculous films were all the rage. Think of Invasion of the Body Snatchers or Swamp Things, and who could forget Attack of the Killer Tomatoes and the classic Little Shop of Horrors. While plants certainly don't invade neighborhoods and gorge themselves on American families, some plants are indeed deadly. One is called Deadly Nightshade, and its delicious-looking berries, a plant that contains atropine and scopolamine, which, if ingested, can leave you hallucinating, delirious, paralyzed, and finally, dead. Eat a handful of castor beans or drink the milk from a cow that's eaten some white snakeroot, and you could also end up dead, just as Abraham Lincoln's mother did. Yep, true story. But today, we'll look at something you shouldn't even go near. In this episode of the Infographics Show, this plant will cause you second-degree burns. The plant in question, the giant hogweed, has lately been making headlines in both the British and American media. Apparently, because of the heatwave in the UK, it's been spreading and causing havoc, and in the US, there have been many reports about authorities trying to stem the growth of the toxic weed. The plant comes from Asia, but has spread around Europe, the USA, and Canada. Before we get into what this plant is and why it causes humans so much pain, we'll give you some examples of people that have run into the hogweed and were left looking like someone threw boiling water at them. Later, we'll also tell you how to avoid that happening and what to do if you get stung by this beast of a plant. In 2018, during a terrible heatwave in the UK, the British press ran a story about a Welsh farmer that almost lost his leg because he'd brushed up against the giant hogweed. The Express newspaper wrote, "He has undergone multiple emergency operations, including one surgery to open his leg from the kneecap to the ankle bone." That's why it's called by the sometimes hyperbolic British tabloid media the most dangerous plant in Britain. You can do a quick Google Images search for this plant, and those photos of blisters might put you off your dinner. It seems the plant enjoys the British countryside, with other recent reports talking about boys and girls being hospitalized and left permanently scarred after coming into contact with the plant. The British media says that it grows mostly along riverbanks, wasteland, and in public parks. The BBC writes that it was introduced to the UK back in 1893 by some idiot that liked the look of it and had it for decorative purposes. After that, we are told the plant escaped from domestication. Okay, so you get the picture. This is one mean plant. But what makes it so dangerous? The Department of Environmental Conservation for New York State has explained why a brush with giant hogweed can lead you to getting burned. This is because the sap in the plant contains something called photosensitizing furanocoumarins. Some plants produce these furanocoumarins to repel predators such as insects or mammals. But when these chemicals hit the skin and interact with sunlight, you can get phytophotodermatitis. Any part of the plant can contain this sap, so whatever you do, don't try and chop one down or hit it with a weed whacker. This bad reaction starts like a bruise, then gets red, and then can turn into horrific blisters. The redness, pain, and swelling can last a couple of weeks, and if you're really unlucky, your injury could become infected, like that farmer from Wales. The scars after the initial bad reaction can last months or even years. Some reports say they can be permanent. It gets worse, too. If you get this sap in your eyes, you could be blinded forever. Though there has been a giant hogweed problem in the US for over a decade, and thankfully, there haven't been any reports of blindness. In 2018, Time magazine said this plant is being found in parts of the USA where it hasn't been seen before. "It's a dangerous plant, but I'm not overly concerned about it. This seems to be an isolated incident," said a professor at Virginia Tech, close to where the unwanted beast had been discovered. Virginia now joins Maine, Michigan, Massachusetts, Connecticut, New York, Vermont, Pennsylvania, North Carolina, Illinois, Washington, and Oregon as states where giant hogweed grows. Another thing that can happen to you is that the area where you get burned can become very sensitive to sunlight for a long time after. One girl in the UK was told that if sunlight ever hit the scars she had, they would re-blister on exposure. She was told to wear sunblock on those areas forever. You should see what happened to that 17-year-old kid in Virginia. It looks pretty darn awful as he took some hits to the face after he tried to chop down a giant hogweed while doing some landscaping. Not only will he have scars on his face that may last a long time, but he'll have to be very careful about exposing that part of his face to the sun for the rest of his life. "I thought it was just a little bit of skin at first, but then big chunks of my face were falling off," he told the press. He was rushed to the hospital and treated for second and third degree burns. So, how can you avoid the giant hogweed, aka Heraclium mantegazianum? As you know by the name, it can grow to a great height, reaching as high as 18 feet. It has a thick, hairy, purple-spotted stem, and its flowers are white. Its leaves are sharp, kind of spiky looking like bat wings. If you see it, report it to the authorities and they will likely do something about it. You see, this thing spreads like wildfire, pardon the pun, as it produces between 20,000 and 50,000 seeds a year that fall as far as 30 feet from the plant and can be taken farther away by wind or water. Given some time, your favorite public park could become infested with these horrible plants, and as happened in Manchester, UK, a fun day out for the kids can turn into a nightmare. Okay, so first of all, whether you're in the UK or the US, you should report it. But let's say you've already brushed up against the hogweed, what do you do next? The first thing is to run cold water on the reddening area and wash it with soap. The quicker you can do this, the better. If you get sap in the eyes, rinse them with cold water and wear sunglasses. Keep any affected area away from sunlight. It's likely if you had the red reaction, you will get some kind of blistering too. Applying topical steroids to that area can help with the pain. If it starts to look bad, head for the hospital. And if your website is looking bad, there's no need to seek professional help. All you need is Wix. With Wix, you can build a safe, robust, fast, and most importantly, modern website. You also have infinite design possibilities. Wix does all the complicated stuff, and it doesn't just host websites, it has a solution for mailboxes, email marketing, and more. No matter what kind of professional solution you need, whether it's something in e-commerce, music, hotels, events, or restaurants, Wix can help you get it done right. So make that website you've been thinking about and support the Infographics Show at the same time by going to wix.com/go/infographics or by clicking the link in the description. So, have you ever come across a giant hogweed? What's the worst reaction you've ever had to a dangerous plant? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called What is the Deadliest Substance on Earth? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!